Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to our celebration of the Holy Mass. Today is our 8th Misa de Gallo. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Mga kapamilya, welcome. Magandang umaga po. At ngayon ho ay malapit na natin mabuo ang ating novena ng Simbang Gabi. Kaya simula ng ating misa ngayon ay muli nating alalahanin ang ating mga intensyon sa pagdulog natin sa Panginoon. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, as the nativity of your Son, according to the flesh, draws near, grant our humble prayer, that you may know the mercy of the Word incarnate, who took flesh of the Virgin Mary and came to dwell among us. We ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Malachi tells us that the prophet Elijah will be sent before the day of the Lord comes. Elijah's coming signals the restoration of communication between God and his people. This reading forms the backdrop for the birth of John, who comes in the spirit of the prophet Elijah.
A reading from the book of the prophet Malachi. Thus says the Lord God, Lo, I am sending my messenger to prepare the way before me, and suddenly there will come to the temple the Lord, whom you seek, and the messenger of the covenant, whom you desire. Yes, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. But who will endure the day of his coming? And who can stand when he appears? For he is like the refiner's fire, or like the fuller's lye. He will sit refining and purifying silver, and he will purify the sons of Levi, refining them like gold or like silver, that they may offer due sacrifice to the Lord. Then the sacrifice of Judah and Jerusalem will please the Lord as in the days of old, as in years gone by. Lo, I will send you Elijah, the prophet, before the day of the Lord comes, the great and terrible day, to turn the hearts of the fathers to their children, and the hearts of the children to their fathers, lest I come and strike the land with doom. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lift up your heads and see your redemption is near at hand.
Lift up your heads and see your redemption is near at hand.
Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your paths, guide me in your truth, and teach me, for you are God, my Savior.
Lift up your heads and see your redemption is near at hand.
Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice. He teaches the humble his way.
Lift up your heads and see your redemption is near at hand.
All the paths of the Lord are kindness and constancy toward those who keep his covenant and his decrees. The friendship of the Lord is with those who fear him and his covenant for their instruction.
Lift up your heads and see your redemption is near at hand. Alleluia, alleluia. O King of all nations and keystone of the church, come and save man, whom you formed from the dust. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the time arrived for Elizabeth to have her child, she gave birth to a son. Her neighbors and relatives heard that the Lord had shown his great mercy toward her, and they rejoiced with her. When they came on the eighth day to circumcise the child, they were going to call him Zechariah after his father. But his mother said in reply, "No, he will be called John." But they answered her, "There is no one among your relatives who has this name." So they made signs, asking his father what he wished him to be called. He asked for a tablet and wrote, "John is his name." And all were amazed. Immediately his mouth was opened, his tongue freed, and he spoke, blessing God. Then fear came upon all their neighbors, and all these matters were discussed throughout the hill country of Judea. And all who heard these things took them to heart, saying, "What then will this child be? For surely the hand of the Lord was with him." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In our Simbang Gabi liturgy, our Simbang Gabi novena is in a sense coming to a climax. Now we have the birth of John the Baptist, and then tomorrow for our final day, we will have that beautiful prayer of Zechariah, the Canticle of Zechariah, the Benedictus. And here you have, I think, something very, not just interesting, but something very important to reflect on in the way Elizabeth and Zechariah responded to what are they to name their child. Here you see that, as we heard in the Gospel, the tradition is you need to name the child according to someone, di ba? Or according to the name of someone in your ancestry. No? In fact, as the Gospel told us, they were planning to name him Zechariah. But, you know, here Elizabeth and Zechariah breaks tradition. When Elizabeth was asked, "Anong papangalan ninyo?" "Juan." Okay, and so everybody was wondering, why? Why will you name him John? No? Wala naman kayong kamag-anak na John. So you see how much the tradition was in a sense questioned or threatened, and therefore the people reacted. So they said, "Okay, let's ask Zechariah," hoping that he would say, "No, he shall be named after me or someone else." No? But then again, Zechariah surprisingly says, writing on the tablet, "His name shall be John." And for me, that is something worth reflecting on, no? As our reflection for today. Number one is that
Elizabeth and Zechariah broke tradition. Kaya yun yung una sa lahat, no? Hindi sila sumunod sa tradisyon na binigyan nila ng pangalan na hindi naaayon sa tradisyon. And I think the breaking of tradition, if you understand what happened, di ba, to Elizabeth and Zechariah, it was their act of gratitude towards God. That they actually named their son as a gift from God, what was exactly their experience of grace. Remember, the name John means, it means that, di ba, una sa lahat, wala sa tradisyon. Di ba? Let's go back to that. Di ba? Wala sa tradisyon. Pero, yung pinili nilang pangalan ay nagsasaad o nagpapahiwatig ng kanilang karanasan ng kabaitan ng Diyos. Tandaan natin ang kahulugan ng pangalan na Juan ay ang Diyos ay mapagbigay. Ang Diyos ay gracious. God is gracious. God is gifting. Ang Diyos ay bukas palad na nagbibigay. And you see that dahil doon sa karanasan nila ng Diyos, ng kabaitan ng Diyos sa kanila, hindi nila sinunod ang tradisyon. And I think this is very important because remember, part of our faith is to get out of our comfort zones. Part of our faith is also to, well, yes, to break tradition, but for a reason. And here the reason of John, or rather of Zechariah and Elizabeth, was because this is our experience of God. And we want to thank God and we want to honor God by naming our son. God is gracious. Yung unang puntong pagnilaya natin. No? And yung pangalawang punto ay, naisip ko, sabi ko, nag-usap kaya si Elizabeth at si John ng matagal kung anong papangalan? Siguro hindi masyado kasi hirap din silang mag-communicate, no? But you would like to think that they were able to arrive at this, again, through prayer and discernment, and through really becoming aware of their experience over that 9 months of the pregnancy of Elizabeth, of Zechariah not being able to speak. Most probably, I would like to think that they spent a lot of time relishing, praying, reflecting on their experience. Those were 9 months of real communion with God. And I guess their experience of God, He's a gracious God. He's a gifting God. And I guess that second point again is an invitation to us to cherish, to relish. No? And as we look back at the past 9 months, magbalik-tanaw tayo. Balikan natin yung ating mga karanasan. At sana dun sa karanasan na yon ay makita natin ang biyaya ng Diyos sa atin, ang presensya ng Diyos. Let us go and reflect back at the last 9 months and once more renew the graces that God has given us and continues to give us, the accompaniment of God with each and every one of us during these last 9 months. And then the third and final point is that it's just good to also reflect on the reaction of the people. When all of these things happened, all of a sudden, Zechariah was able to speak. Even, di ba, yung pagkapipi ni Zechariah, ano na yan eh, kamangha-mangha na yan, nagtataka na yung mga tao. Sabi nga, di ba, sa Ebanghelyo, na sabi ng mga tao, may nangyari siguro sa loob nung nagdadasal siya, kaya paglabas niya, pipi na siya. No? And here now, all of a sudden, he speaks. And all of a sudden, now, they realize that this baby, this John, is someone who is different. And as the gospel tells us, no, and the people were in awe, no, they were in awe. And then they ask, what then will this child be? For surely the hand of the Lord was with him. And I guess it's very important also to think about that. That the witness that we give to God's graciousness can have an impact on other people. And I hope this is something that we will take to heart. That we will allow people to realize the greatness and the goodness of God. So today, let us continue to pray as we come to our final days, actually, today and tomorrow of our Simbang Gabi Novena. Let us pray that God may use us as His instrument to bring hope, to bring again His presence of greatness and goodness in the lives of our people. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Zechariah called his son John, meaning God is gracious. Trusting in God's graciousness and generosity, we pray.
Lord, be gracious to us.
That church and government leaders may show God's graciousness by their loving and persevering service to God's people, we pray.
Lord, be gracious to us.
That we may come to appreciate our Christian names and dignity and live up to our baptismal promises, we pray.
Lord, be gracious to us.
That we may become a united and caring community where sorrow is halved and joy is multiplied, we pray.
Lord, be gracious to us.
That families who gather together at Christmas and the New Year may renew their love, solidarity, and support for one another, we pray.
Lord, be gracious to us.
That the Lord may grant to the souls of our brothers and sisters the reward of eternal life, we pray.
Lord, be gracious to us.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord, be gracious to us.
Loving Father, watch over your people. May we strive to please you at all times. This we ask to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord God, let the sacrifice you have given us, the full expression of the church's worship, establish us firmly in your peace, that we may celebrate with untroubled hearts the coming birth of our Savior, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Thank you.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata.
God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them, and grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. Grant pardon and peace, O Lord, to those who you have fed with heavenly gifts, so that at the coming of your beloved Son, we may hasten to greet him with lamps alight in our hands. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Hasten to the aid of your faithful people who call you, O Lord, we pray, and graciously give strength in their human weakness, so that being dedicated to you in complete sincerity, they may find gladness in your remedies, both now and in the life to come, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon us and remain with us forever.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.